Okay, hello students. Today we are going to study information collection and strategies for information collection. So information collection, it's also known as data collection. Every technical writing in its planning stage needs to data, and we collect the data by references and following the bibliography. We read several books, we research in the real market, we take interviews, we study journals, online journals, we visit libraries to get the required information, and we talk to the experts in order to get a sufficient pack of data with the help of which we can compose our writing, whether it is a report writing, whether it is a research report, or whether it is a proposal, business proposal writing, when you are going to work for a new business establishment. So all these things need appropriate data collection. So the next step after you decide your objective, scope and purpose of data collection, whether you are collecting the data for performing a research study or for writing a business proposal, you try to recognize the technique of data collection. So, recognizing the sources of information and collecting information becomes the primary task at this stage, at the data collection step. Formal writing cannot depend on imagination, as we know, or any assumptions. It requires complete evidence, a solid proof content, so that the readers can trust it or your writing can be taken for granted. So this marks the importance of data collection in any report writing. So we look at the sources on which we can depend, or we can go for our data, we can work out for our data. That can be your encyclopedias, it is the world of information, textbooks, office records, files, journals, handbooks, that can be government publications, that can be internet sources, for example, YouTubes, the journals, articles. They are not often available in library hard copies, so we have to rely on internet, then magazines and journals, newspapers and computer databases. So all these are the sources where we look into for collecting any effective data. Once again, we should keep in mind that the purpose of writing decides the data collection techniques. Now, the methods of data collection we are going to look here now. There are several methods, as you said, as per your need, or you can use one method or you can use two or all to get a sufficient, a satisfying data that can be helpful for your next purpose of technical writing. Even why not it be for your resume writing? You can refer to other sources, other books or internet sources. You can look at other sample CV or resumes and you can borrow the idea from there and write for your own. So this is creativity, and data collection is the tool that helps you in creating new piece of technical writing. So we here see different methods for data collection. The firstly, there are four mentioned here: personal observation, telephonic interviews, personal interview, and mail questionnaire. We'll discuss each one by one. So let's come to the personal observation method of data collection. In personal observation, some reports are based on your personal observations. For example, you may be required to write a report on an experiment you conducted in the laboratory, a job you performed, or an event to which you were an eyewitness. In all these situations, you rely on your sensory perceptions, your imaginations, your own mental works, and hence you should develop careful observation so that it can be later resourced and referred as data. Then you have the second method, telephonic interview. So in telephonic interview, see, the writers, if you want to write about a writer, you conduct a telephonic interview with him, and that is very convenient and your time saving. Another method, so we consider, is telephonic interview. It is personal on telephonic. If the information you seek is of a routine nature and only brief answers are required from a small number of people, then you can prefer this method, the telephone, and save your time on traveling and money as well. But often you may not get as effective a feedback on the telephone as it is possible through a personal interview. Telephonic conversation is one way, and it may not be so much suggestive or imaginative, it may not be so dynamic, but it can be one shorter, smarter way of collecting a data, of taking a data. Then it comes to the next step of data collection, your personal interview. As we said, while collecting data by conducting personal interviews, you should be assured, observant, and sensitive to the reaction of the person you are interviewing. That means you have a preview, a raw view, idea of that person, and sometimes this may interrupt your understanding to the point. You may not thoroughly get the interpretation of that person you are interviewing to. So you must be quick and readjust your approach and attitude to suit your case. Every individual has a different approach, and you need to firstly adjust with him mentally and psychologically. You need to first secure a person's attention, excite his interest, because it is equally necessary on his part that he is interested in answering you in your writing. So you need to establish a rapport so that he or she responds and cooperates in giving you the information that you want. And this depends on your knack of handling people. So you must be very much skilled handling people so that you can take them in your flow, in your mood, in your interest, for your purpose, influencing them. First, when you are conducting personal interview, do your own homework, prepare your questions, all little and large questions. The set of questions that you prepare for this purpose will be called an interview sheet. So that will help you to finally attain your desired and satisfactory data from this method of personal interview. Then we move to the last form of data collection, that is mail questionnaire. Usually this is a common practice these days. It saves your time and efficiency. You need to just know the mail ID of the concerned specialist or person whom you want to make questions. So you mail them the questions. When a wide geographical coverage is required to be covered and a large number of people have to be contacted, this can prove the most efficient and convenient method, that is to collect data through mail questionnaires. For one, it is not possible in a very short time and with a limited budget of research to perform the above three steps. He cannot visit the different geographical areas in a short time for his research study or for collecting the data that will be useful for him in his studies. So he can better mail them the questionnaires. Questionnaires means the list of questions what he has desired, the data collector, and he can mail them and request them for their ideal responses. So this is what your fourth mode of collecting a data. Then we have, once our data is collected, we have to further process them, and this we discuss in analyzing and organizing the data. Already we have in our previous chapters discussed how to organize the data, that means with suitable format, with suitable structure and language. You can refer back to those sections also, include that part in this also, but I will have a short reference here. So analyzing and organizing data, in short we can say, once data is collection is done and notes have been taken, the next step for the report writer is to analyze the data. As a report writer, therefore, you should determine more valuable information from the data collected. Revise your questions and data. Add new item to it if necessary. And finally, arrange, that is organize systematically, the data in the required formal report. If you're writing a research report or a research article, it may have its particular format. If you're writing a business report, it has a different, and if you're writing a proposal, business proposal, it will have a different format. So the required format or the desired format you choose, and you organize your data accordingly into it. The report structure has already been discussed in the previous lessons. So this is the short idea about data collection we had. Now there will be a question, theoretical question, that to define or introduce data collection, including what are the different methods of collecting data or information and organizing them. So students, we come to the end of data collection. Thank you.